We are going to see about one of the useful feature as well as widely used feature of MongoDB, that is full text search. Do remember that MongoDB is a document oriented database. So websites or applications for news, listing or blog based systems uses full text search heavily. And similarly, analysis systems and reporting systems also use full text search. Without full text search, a similar result can also be obtained using regular expressions in MongoDB or by using like in SQL. But full text search will be very accurate, faster, and has intelligence embedded because there will be a separate engine for processing these full text searches, which uses specific algorithms to get the right results. Some of the features of a full text search engine are listed here. Among this, word breakers or tokenization and stemming are the most important ones. Tokenization is for splitting a text or sentences into meaningful words, whereas stemming, for example, if you are going to search for a word important, the search results will have the word importance also included. And similarly, if you are going to search for queries, the word queries, the search result will have query also included. Ranking. Every search result has a score, that's what is referred as ranking. And similarly, stop word skipping is for skipping common words like and, the, etc. Soundex, this feature currently we don't have in MongoDB. This is used for searching related words having similar phonetics. There are many advantages of full text search, especially for searching logs, blogs, and other website text content. There is a well-known disadvantage also because the index size is going to be huge. That is a known factor. That's what a lot of cloud service providers doesn't support full text search. In MongoDB, doing a text search is very, very easy and simple. The syntax is very clear, as you can see. The first term is the search string. The all other three are optional. The language specification. Currently, MongoDB supports only 15 languages. I hope later they will add more. Then whether the search is case sensitive or not, and finally whether you want to do a diacritic search or not. The only prerequisite is that we have to create a text index on the field we are going to search. We'll be covering these topics and they are very, very easy. Let us proceed to the demo now. To demonstrate about full text index, we'll be using a collection by name articles. In that, I have created a text index already. I'll be removing that and we'll be seeing what will happen when we don't have a text index. As you can see here, there are two indexes are available on this articles collection. So the first one is a regular one that is on the underscore ID field, and the second one is on the subject text field. So if we query the documents in Tableau view, as you can see here, we have four fields. One is the ID auto-generated field, subject field, author field, and views field. We are going to do a text search on this field, and I'm going to search on that. Removing an index is very easy. Let me do that. Collections.remove. Drop index. The name of the index is subject underscore text. Let me drop that. Let me confirm it by querying again. So we have only one index. There is no text index. Now let us see the syntax for text search. This is the syntax. You just need to specify the search string. And in view documents, let me get the search string for this. So I'll be searching for the word coffee. db.articles.find. $text search and the search text. So if you do this search on this, you'll be getting an error message. So the error message is text index record for the text query. This is the error message we'll be getting if you haven't done a text index, because we dropped the existing text index on this field, which I have created already. So creating a text index is very simple. Create a text index here. db.articles.createIndex we have. You can create multiple index also. I'll be using only one now. And for the field name is subject. And the type of index is text. This must create a text index on this field. The field name is subject, type must be text. So number of indexes before was 1, that was on the ID field, and the number of indexes after is 2. So let me confirm it again by using get indexes. So we got the index on this field. Now let us execute the same query now. So this is the result. This is a text search result. You can see coffee is there, and even the capital letter coffee is also included. So in table view, this will be very clear. Coffee, coffee and cream, and coffee shopping is there. Let us see a cool feature about full text search. In this collection, if you see the documents here, we have in the subject field, we have something called importance in the subject, and similarly we have query in the subject. Let me show how it can be selected in full text search. That's very easy. Articles dot find, it's going to be a text search with the search term is going to be, we have seen query. I'm going to give here as queries. I forgot to put a circular bracket. So this is the interesting thing about full text search, that if you search for queries, you'll be getting the result for query. So it automatically finds these two are related and it is listed in the result. And the same thing happens for importance also. Importance. If I search for importance, I'll be getting for importance, but even if I search for important, the search result will have this. So this is the interesting thing about the full text search. It has an algorithm or the database to match words by their relevance. So the next one we are going to see about this one, stop words will be skipped. So in case if I'm going to give the search again with the words and or the result will be same. As you can see here, this and this will get the same result even with the. So these are the stop words that will be skipped. The next one we are going to see about exclude content in the search text. That's very easy. Similar to Google search, you just need to put a negation mark. So in the above search, if I'm going to mention that I don't want cream in the result, it will list only two. So that's negation. It's similar to Google search. So this is for negation. Now for multiple search, that's very easy. I wish to have these three words to be listed in the search result. On firing this query, we must see the search result has the new words also included, importance and query. So this is how multiple search works. The next important thing is case sensitive search. That's very easy. As you can see in the syntax, case sensitive search, we just need to specify Boolean value. So we are going to use the same one, but this time this will have a different result, because as you can see here, one of the result is having a capital letter word in the beginning. That's coffee shopping is having a capital letter C in the beginning. So this will get filtered out from the search result if you are going to make a case sensitive search. Let's see that. That's very easy. Case sensitive is true. So the results will be 4 now. As we expected, the result is 4. That's how case sensitive works. Now let us search the exact phrase. Again, this is also is very easy. I'm going to take this one. I'm going to paste this one here. Coffee and cream. But this is not an exact phrase. This will list all the ones with coffee and cream. So to make an exact phrase search, you just need to add this one here as well as at the end. So this will get you the exact phrase like this. So this is how the phrase searching works. The next interesting thing is the diacritic search. If we see the syntax here, there is an option for diacritic sensitive search. So you just need to specify a Boolean value for this. So in our collection data, if you can see here, in this field subject, there are two values, cafe con leche. I think this is in Spanish. Similarly, there is the same text is repeated here, but in this one, you can see a diacritic mark over here. That's the apostrophe. So if you make this one diacritic sensitive, it must only fetch exactly the same text if you are going to specify this in the search text. Let us see how this is going to work. Instead of case sensitive, we are going to give diacritic sensitive as true, and here this is going to be the search text. View document. Let me copy this one and paste it here. So we have the apostrophe mark here. On execution, you must see only the exact text searched here. That is because we have specified this as diacritic sensitive. In the previous versions of MongoDB, diacritic sensitive was by default true, but in the later editions, they have made this as false. So if you're going to make this one as false, you must see two rows here. I mean, to document selected because diacritic sensitive is false. So the one without apostrophe mark is also got selected. But when we make this one as true, we must see exactly one document which has a matching apostrophe mark as specified in the search query. The next key thing we'll be learning is about the text score. The text operator automatically assigns scores to each document in the search results based on its relevance. So we're going to display it. For that, we'll be using the meta projection operator. So it's a projection operator, so it comes in the second part of the find query. The syntax is very simple, as you can see here. So let me copy this. This must display the scores associated with the search results. I'm just going to replace this query with a text operator. So this is the one, and the collection name is going to be articles. On execution, we must see the documents listed along with their meta score. I mean the text score. So this is the score for the documents. To sort the results, it's very easy. Just you need to specify the same inside the sort method. I think I made a mistake here. Braces was missing. Let me add that. So the documents got ordered by the score. That's what the sort method does. So with this, we are successfully finishing about full text search. Now let us move to the next chapter.